Hi everyone, I'm Sanil Rege, consultant psychiatrist. Today I'll be talking about the effect of SSRIs on emotions and the phenomenon of emotional blunting. Now thank you very much to the viewer who raised this important question. And what I'm going to talk about is the range of emotional disturbances that have been described by patients when on SSRIs and of course also on SNRIs, because it is the serotonin component that is closely associated with this particular side effect. Now, although emotional blunting is a side effect, we will see that SSRIs and SNRIs also treat anxiety because they actually reduce the aversive stimuli through the same mechanism. Now, there was an interesting qualitative study done by Price that was published that looked at a number of forums and analyzed what patients who were on these medications described in terms of emotional blunting or the emotional changes. So these were the seven important aspects that were described. The first one is the general effect on all emotions. Most participants described a general reduction in the intensity of all emotions that they experienced. And these were often described as dulled or numbed or flattened or completely blocked, as well as descriptions of feeling blank and flat. Now, it's not uncommon for patients to come and say, you know, doctor, I've taken the medication, I feel better, my anxiety's gone down, my mood's improved a little bit, but I just don't feel anything, I feel numb. Or in some cases, in extreme cases, the ability to cry, for example, or express significant laughter is also dulled down. And this can be extremely distressing. And this is why some patients can sometimes talk about, or family members might say, you know, the reactiveness is not the same. The personality is a bit different. It's not uncommon to hear that description as well. Second, there is a reduction of positive emotions. And this is associated with sort of worsening that almost an anhedonia in a way. So it might not treat the anhedonic component adequately. So again, in this study, they described a reduction in their positive emotions, which they attributed to the SSRI antidepressant. And the reduction was really both reduced intensity and reduced frequency of these positive emotions. And they described a reduction in a wide range of positive emotions, which included happiness, enjoyment, excitement, anticipation, passion, love, affection, and enthusiasm. And you can see that this particular side effect can also be linked to that sexual dysfunction. And interestingly, there's a positive correlation between emotional blunting and sexual dysfunction as well. So, which means that a high number of individuals who have sexual dysfunction also have emotional blunting. The words that were used were dampened down or toned down. Third, there was reduction of negative emotions. Now this obviously helps. This is one of the positive aspects because it actually treats depression and anxiety. Individuals experienced a reduction of intensity or frequency of negative emotions. And the negative emotions commonly described as reduced included sadness, emotional pain, distress, anger, irritability, aggression, anxiety, worry, or fear. So this is one of the treatment aspects related to SSRIs. The fourth one was emotional detachment. And here participants described feeling emotionally detached or disconnected, and again attributed to the antidepressant. And some individuals felt detached from their surroundings. They talked about kind of being in limbo, unreality, disconnection, or feeling that they were a spectator rather than an actual participant in their life. They described themselves as a zombie or a robot. So quite unpleasant again. The next one, just not caring. So individuals talked about just not being bothered. And this is where this is linked to that apathy sort of side effect. And there are instances, case studies, where treatment of OCD, where individuals have been described as significantly apathetic with significant affection of their frontal lobe as well. So they cared less about themselves, about other people, and about the consequences of their action as well. Next, changed personality. Some participants felt that their personality had changed so that they'd been lost, leaving them like a shell. This is not uncommon where people talk about losing their creativity as well. And interestingly, SSRIs are a treatment, for example, for pathological crying or pathological laughing or impulsive discontrol after a stroke, for example. So we know that it can actually blunt these extreme emotions as well. Next, they talked about it's because of my pills. The emotional effects that we talked about, the previous points, they attributed these to the SSRI antidepressant, either in total or in part. What is the mechanism of emotional blunting? You see, obviously, I'll talk about a scanning study that has been done, but essentially we know that SSRIs, and we've covered a video on this, SSRIs actually increase serotonin in the synaptic cleft by blocking the transporter, SERT, and the serotonin then acts on the 5-HT2A receptor amongst the other receptors. But the 5-HT2A receptor, when activated, has a inhibitory effect on frontal dopamine. And we know that the frontal lobe dopamine is necessary for to experience emotions, hedonic drive, motivation, etc. So basically, this reduction of frontal dopamine is linked to emotional blunting. Now, there is another part of the brain that's also affected, which is the anterior cingulate cortex. And anterior cingulate cortex is a really important area for emotions, again, mediated through dopamine, noradrenaline. So it is postulated that SSRIs and SNRIs also affect dopaminergic and noradrenergic aspects in this anterior cingulate cortex. There is a study, McCabe, published in 2010, that looked at, and this was about 45 healthy participants. They were randomized to receive, so double blind, they were randomized to receive citalopram, or SSRI, or reboxetine, which is a NARI, a noradrenergic reuptake inhibitor. What that means is it essentially increases levels of noradrenaline and also dopamine. So no serotonin there. And of course, the last one was placebo, and they received it for 7 days. Now, these are healthy participants, so note they're not individuals with depression. And then they used functional magnetic resonance imaging. What functional magnetic MRI does is it provides functioning of the different parts of the brain. And what they did was they used this FMRI to measure the neural response to rewarding stimuli and aversive stimuli. Now, the rewarding stimuli was the sight and or the flavor of chocolate. So both seeing and the flavor of chocolate. The aversive stimuli was the sight of moldy strawberries and or an unpleasant strawberry taste. And what they found was really, really interesting. They found that citalopram, the SSRI, reduced the activation to the chocolate stimuli in the ventral striatum and the ventral medial orbitofrontal cortex. Now, this striatum to the orbitofrontal cortex is really a key pathway for that hedonic drive, for that pleasure. So we can see that that frontal lobe that I talked about is affected. So it reduced that activation in this key part of the brain. In contrast, reboxetine did not suppress ventral striatal activity and in fact increased the neural responses within the medial orbitofrontal cortex to reward. Not surprising, because it increases dopamine, noradrenaline, and these are dopaminergic or noradrenergic antidepressants, which we know we need to use in depression, for example, where dopamine levels, the frontal lobe symptoms are quite prominent. We covered this in the melancholic depression video that we did. And citalopram also decreased neural responses to the aversive stimuli conditions in key punishment areas, such as the lateral orbitofrontal cortex. So you can see SSRIs, by reducing the aversive stimuli, actually provides that benefit that occurs in anxiety. Reboxetine did a similar thing, albeit a weaker effect. So you see, in anxiety, often reduction of that aversive stimuli helps. And that's why the S component, SSRIs and SNRIs, in terms of medication, are considered first line in anxiety. So that blunting response is a side effect, but in many cases is also that treatment. So achieving a balance becomes very, very important. So really, what's the message? The message is that SSRIs can diminish the neural processing of both rewarding and aversive stimuli. So in this case, you know, chocolate and of course the moldy strawberries. So the big question is, how do we treat emotional blunting, or how do we prevent this? Now, firstly, there are newer antidepressants. such as vortioxetine, such as agomelatine, or even considering broader spectrum agents. Now, mirtazapine at higher doses provides that dopamine or adrenaline, does not blunt the frontal lobe. So mirtazapine is another agent. But agomelatine, vortioxetine, these are known agents that can treat emotional blunting, and often by switching from SSRI to vortioxetine or agomelatine. But in some cases, augmentation strategies may also be used. Now, this is something that should be discussed with the doctor, which means that one can keep the dose of the SSRI low, because sometimes individuals find if the dose goes up, the emotional blunting becomes worse or it becomes prominent, in which case, by keeping the dose of the SSRI low or SNRI low and adding an agent that does not lead to emotional blunting or that pushes dopamine in the frontal lobe can provide the benefits of the SSRI and also prevent the emotional blunting. So these are some of the strategies, but of course prevention is probably the best strategy, which means choosing an antidepressant that has a lower incidence of these side effects. Agomelatine, vortioxetine, mirtazapine are agents to think about. So I hope that this gives an idea about emotional blunting and the effect of SSRIs, SNRIs on the emotional responses. If you liked the video, of course, leave us a like. Look forward to seeing you in another video soon. Take care and stay safe. Bye-bye.